right where you are. It's Cyberchase for real.
Today, I'm doing something I've always wanted to do. Go to the Bronx Zoo. I'm meeting my cousin Kimmie.
Sup, cuz?
Hey, Booker.
It's amazing to see all these animals living in the middle of New York City.
I know. I love coming here.
I like checking out all the different places where animals live.
Me too. I like seeing how the people here provide the animals with the things they need.
Right. Sea lions live in water, and they like to eat fish.
You know, I read that most of the water sea lions need comes from the fish they eat, not from seawater.
Fun fact. Whoa. I can watch penguins all day.
Like the sea lions, they also like water and land.
I read on a sign, it said their bird pals are Inca terns.
Yep. Penguins and Inca terns like these share the same habitat in South America.
Here, they have lots of space to fly.
And they can make nests in the cliffs.
It looks like this habitat has a den to sleep in.
And water for cooling off.
It's so great to see all these animals up close, so we can learn about them.
Scientists also learn about wildlife in a natural habitat right here, at the zoo.
What do you mean?
Follow me. I want you to meet some friends.
12.5 inches.
And the tail?
11.5 inches.
Hey, Kyanna. Hi, Noor.
Hi, you must be Booker.
Hey, is that a snapping turtle?
Yep.
That is not an animal I'm happy to see. When I swim in the lake, I worry one might bite me.
No need to worry. Snapping turtles usually don't mind sharing water where humans also swim. As long as we don't bother them, they tend to go and hide in the mud or grass.
Actually, you should be happy to see her. Years ago, animals struggled to survive here because the Bronx River was polluted.
What changed?
Well, people in the community helped clean up the river. So now, snapping turtles and other animals, like egrets, ducks, and fish, can live here.
And snapping turtles return the favor. They help keep the river healthy by eating all kinds of things. Worms, insects, fish, and plants.
Wow, I didn't know that. But what are you doing with snapping turtles?
Well, we're collecting information to help scientists understand how well snapping turtles are doing in their habitat.
What kind of information?
We're counting how many we're finding. And to monitor their health, we're measuring the turtles' shells and tails.
It's sort of like when you go to the doctor's for a checkup. That is awesome.
That's right. And since she's so big, we know that she's been living a healthy life here for about 20 years.
So to keep wildlife healthy, we need to do everything we can to protect their habitats, especially in the places that we share.
Right, like making sure trash, especially plastic, doesn't end up in rivers, lakes, and the ocean. Then more snapping turtles and other animals can live happily ever after.
Watch your favorite shows anytime on the PBS KIDS video app.